Yo, I don't think we should talk about this.
Come on, why not?
People might misunderstand what we're trying to say.
No, what's the problem?
Afternoon, everyone, depending on what your time frame is. Merry Christmas. Please do start sharing, begin to invite people to join into this topic. We want to talk about sex, three-letter word that everybody don't want to talk about in the public, but we all do it in behind closed door. We all enjoy it, but we don't want to talk about it, you know, in the public. But yet, it's very important. Yet, it's a do or die, if I may say. Thank you all for joining in, my pretty able people. Thank you, Adeni Oyedele, Sahid, Modupe Ola, John. Thanks for joining in all the way from Nigeria. It's Boxing Day today. Happy Boxing Day. Okay, so are we ready to box? No, we are not boxing today. We were talking about sex today. And after the show, I want you to go meet your spouse. for the lucky ones that are married anyway, go to your husband, go to your wife, and put some of the actions into practice. Okay? Let me start seeing your fingers working. Start sharing and share and share and share. Begin to share it as we go on to this topic. I'm going to try not to be very raw. I'm going to try to be practical at the same time. But then I need your contribution. We all know what sex is. Let's not pretend. Okay, it's not being preached on the pulpit because we are all trying to be spiritually correct and politically correct, and we're all trying to avoid being persecuted. Okay, so but I'm bold enough to come on air and talk about it. Why? Because I've seen it, you know, I've seen the benefits and I've seen the disadvantage, and I've seen what it does even to our community in the whole world. You know, whether we like it or not, it's very important. And if God has made it so, there's a reason why God created sex. He made man and he made female. He made them one. And what made them one is when they come together in sexual intercourse. That's when they become one. So there's nothing to be shy about. It's nothing to run from. Okay? So let's not persecute ourselves. Let's not judge ourselves. Let's not condemn ourselves when God has not. The only time when it becomes sin, the only time when we may feel bad about it is when we're involved in it outside marriage. Okay, so I'm going to be talking to mostly married people. But for those who are not even married, learn and prepare yourself. Okay, because when we talk about sex, sex did not start, you know, and should not start only after marriage. No. What do I mean by that? Before you get married to your partner, there's something that you saw called attraction. Something attracted you. And you cannot have sex with somebody you are not attracted to. It's not possible. You cannot have sex with somebody you are not attracted to. So talking to singles, talking to those who are not married yet and you're looking out there for the right partner, it's very important to know if you're sexually attracted to your partner, to that man, to that woman, you know, that is eyeing you or that you are eyeing, that's been talking to you, you know, that you also have been like, okay, I think I want to consider him. Or you're already in a relationship. Before you tie the knot, are you sexually attracted to that person? Is the person sexually attracted to you? Is there anything about them that, you know, you look at them and you feel aroused? And if you cannot tell yourself, oh, I like my husband, I like the way he walks, I love his lips, you know, I love his legs, I love his hands, they just turn me on when I look at it, then there's a problem. That's where it all starts from. There is a problem. So that man, that woman, that is, are you sexually attracted to the person? And that's also looking at compatibility. Compatibility when it comes to sex. Are you compatible? How do you know? Okay, I'm not married and I'm not expected to have sex before marriage. So how do I know if I'm sexually compatible with this person? From the way you talk, you will know. From charisma, you will know. There are some people that even their smell, their aura, you know, arouses you naturally. If you don't have that feeling, that kind of feeling, you need to double check. What am I doing? And am I in the right relationship? Okay, thanks for joining in. On Lowo, JT Creation, Popsy, thanks for joining in. Please don't just join in by watching. Do contribute. Especially Mr. Akinola, okay, don't come and scrutinize me later. Begin to talk now about sex in marriage, about understanding one another, you know, about even before you get married, what are those signs you look at for to know this person will be sexually compatible with them? Are they going to be able to meet your needs? And we all differ. Some people, their sexual drive is not very high, you know, the like old school lapel. But some people, they're adventurers in bed. They're adventurers, they like to try new things and all that. Your partner, is it that kind of a person? The person you want to marry, the person you want to settle down with, do you think they'll be able to play ball with you? The person you want to marry, are they even your friend? Are they your friend? Can you talk to them at any time? Can you express yourself without feeling shy? Can you express yourself with them without feeling bad? Can you express yourself with them without feeling, oh, he's going to think I'm wayward. He's going to think I'm a street girl if I ask him to do it this way, if I ask him to do it that way. Is your partner your friend? So before you say yes, think twice. Before you say yes, think twice. Do share. Thank you all, Mudupola. For some reason, I don't know why I cannot bring you up on video. Maybe I've pressed some wrong button. Trying to be too technical. Okay. But then your tests, your comments are welcome. I'll read them out and we will deliberate more on them. And I believe also if you want to join in, you can join in by video, by testing, and let's deliberate. What is really the problem that men and women are having in their matrimonial home when it comes to sex? A lot of people are going through a lot, but they are shy to talk about it. They are shy to ask for help. But the truth is, it needs to be talked about. A solution needs to be looked for, arrived at, and practicalized. There's so many ways to go about it. There's so many ways. Some couples go for counseling even before their pastors, and they can't really say what the problem is. They beat about the bush and talk about so many things. But their main problem is sex. But they're so shy to talk about it. So if you don't feel confident talking to your pastor, the first person you should even talk to is your partner. Listen, this is it. I'm not happy with our sex life. Talk about it. Find solution together. What's this? You know, when you deny yourself sex, or when your partner denies you sex, pleasure, and satisfaction, it's a constructive abandonment. It's an abandonment on its own, you know. It's an alienation of affection, not affection between the two of you. The affection drive is zero. So, and then when we talk about this problem, it comes in different category. To some people, it's just maybe once a week, twice a week. To some people, it's once a month. So in one of three marriages, they're having problem that is related to sex. Nothing else. Sex problem. I think 2 years ago when I was writing my book, Are You Ready? I did some research. And I still double-checked the research as at yesterday. It's still the same. You know, 15 of 20 marriages that end up in divorce is sex-related problem. So it's a serious problem. It's not a problem fasting and prayer can solve. No, it's a problem you need to talk about. It's a problem you need to work on. It's a problem you need to find solution. It's a problem you need to practicalize. It's not a problem to be shy about, but it's a problem that can destroy your marriage. If 15 out of 20 marriages that go through divorce are sex-related problems, then it's something serious that you need to look into, starting from before you say, I do. A lot of people, you know, let me say, a lot of us, we've had sex with our partners before we got married. So during that time of courtship, if you're not happy, if you don't feel fulfilled, and if you think this person can't give it to me the way I want or can't take me to the climax, don't be shy and don't marry out of pity. If you are able to teach each other, you know, either through reading sex books, Bluefin, some people will tell you, oh, it's a sin to watch Bluefin. Sit down there and destroy your marriage. Sit down there. The Bible doesn't teach you the practicality of sex. Apart from the few bits that is mentioned in Song of Solomon, where Solomon was expressing, you know, his desire and appraising the wife, the Shunammite wife. That's the only place where there's a bit of sex talk. Appraising the beauty, the way our nose is like the tower, her breast is like something looking at something. She's beautiful, black, ebony, and all that. That's the only place. But in most other places, they talk about marriage, but not sex. Okay, so, but yet, the truth of it is, Most marriages are suffering. Most marriages are suffocating, you know, on this sex issue. So where do you go for help? The Quran won't help you on this matter. The Bible won't help you on this matter. You need to seek for help either through sex therapies. There are people who have trained themselves, who are professional. They can help you. Sex therapies are there. Counselors are there. There are sex help books. There are blue film are there. They have, you know, there are a lot of things you can do to help yourself. The more knowledge you seek, the more knowledgeable you get. If you want to be spiritually inclined, then you read your Bible, you read books that are related to that, you watch movies that are related to that. When you want to be a nurse, you go for nursing school, you read books that are related to nursing. When you want to talk about beauty, you go to beauty therapy, you read about beauty. You even see a lot of movies, clips on YouTube that teach you how to put on your makeup. I learned all my makeup drama on YouTube. So you can learn on that. But when we want to talk about sex, then you need to go to the sex therapies. You need to go to people who are involved in it. They may be Christian, they may not be Christian, but so far you get what you want and you keep your marriage. What is the crime in watching blue movie? We all do, but we come and lie and pretend like we are holy than thou. Sit down with your partner. Watch blue film. It arouses you. Then look at what are the problem, the challenges that make us to shy away from sex in marriage. Sometimes it's fatigue. Sometimes it's stress. Sometimes it's depression. You know, sometimes there are issues between couples that needs to be resolved. There are ongoing issues that need to be resolved. And nobody's talking about it. You're not resolving the problem. But you want to go ahead, you know, and just come and say, okay, come, let's have sex. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. So if there are issues between you and your husband, you and your wife, you and your partner, you need to sit down and talk about it. You need to make peace. You need to make amends. Okay? You need to make amends. The greatest thing to do, the greatest way forward, the greatest step for a good sex drive is communication. So when there's no communication, where do we even start from? It's at the end of the year, I will even call that partial rape, if there's anyone like that. Consensual rape, if there's another word like that. I'm not very sure. But just like, okay, let it be. You're not doing it out of happiness, so there's no satisfaction. Gradually, it's constructive abandonment. You abandon your wife, you abandon your husband. Now, this topic, the sex problem in marriage, is talking to the man and to the woman. Nobody is a saint on this topic. Nobody is a saint. So what are you doing wrong as a man? What are you doing wrong as a woman? You've refused to be taught. You've refused to learn. I can't do more than this, so I cannot come and kill myself. You are not killing yourself, but if you love your wife, if you love your husband, you need to learn to improve yourself. Just like if you don't know how to cook very well, you need to learn how to cook better. Because you don't want the people who can cook better than you to take your husband from you. And you're not going to go and learn from another man. You're going to learn with your man. Two of you are going to practicalize. You're going to work on it. You're going to tutor yourself. You're going to get better in it. You're going to get better in it. Now, I've been to a few sex sites. Not sex sites. What's it called now? Oh, come on. What's this site called? I'm not going to give you the name. Dating sites. I've been to few. And some are not very popular because they're not really dating sites. But they are sex sites. That's the word for it. But that's not what they call it. They call it different names. And as I made friends with few men. I made friends with few men. Trust me. I made friends with about 10 men, you know. Call it investigative journalism, call it research, call it whatever. I made friends with 10 men. Out of the 10 men, 8 of them are married. 8 of them are married. And out of those 8, I physically went out to meet 2 of them. Because I wanted to meet, I wanted to talk to them to really understand what the hike I do on this side if you are married. What are you doing on this side if you're married? And the bottom line is this, that they're on the side for sex. I don't understand. You're married and you're on the side looking for sex. It's called, there's one they called No String Attached. No NSS. No String Attached. Sex with benefits. Some sex without benefit. No string attached relationship. What the heck is going on? No string attached. That means I want to be your friend. If I like you, if there's chemistry between us, then we go out and have fun. We go out and have sex. And that's the end of it. If I feel like having you next time, I'll just call you. And then we go and have sex. But no string attached. I don't owe you nothing. I don't have to buy you anything. I don't have to spend money on you. I'm not committed to you in any way. And I'm like, what the heck is going on? If you have a wife and you think your sex drive or how your wife's sex drive is low, what are you doing to help her? How many women? How many men? Because it's funny enough, there are men there, there are women. I saw women from the age of 25 up to the age of 50. Most of them are married. But I was more interested in the men. So, because that's the opposite sex I can attract and talk to. And they were all married, yet they are looking for NSS, no string attached relationship. Why? Because they are not happy at home. Why? Because they don't have that relationship satisfaction. Now, there are other factors all related to this, but the main one I want to talk about is sex. Because in any relationship that is sexually active will not have problem. You will not. If you fight in the morning, before night, you will solve that problem. You will solve the fight. Because why? You want to get to the bottom. Why? Because you want to sleep with your wife. You want to sleep with your husband. And you know that if you are still fighting with him or her, there is no show. All the doors are closed. And because of that, you will make peace. Either by trick or by crook. Either honestly or whichever way you want to solve the problem. Now, there are problems, there are issues that arrive that bring about women not after few years in marriage, you know, from few people I've cancelled and from a bit of research I've done, a lot of marriages suffer sex problem or their sex drive kind of go boom in the air like that because of fatigue, because of financial problem, you know, emotional problem, depression, frustration. So when we talk about sexual problem, it's one out of many. Something led to that. Something led to the problem. So why don't we look at the root of the problem? It's not enough to just you as a man to just shout at your wife. You can't just shout at her and then shun her or say, no, I have to do this. You have to give me. It's my right. It's my this. As much as it is your right, it is also our right either to accept or to decline. So that's why I say communication is important. What is the root of the problem? If you get the root of the problem, then you can find a solution. A lot of people I've spoken to, I did a questionnaire. And in the early age stage of their marriage, a lot of them will tell you, oh, sex was beautiful. We could not get our hands off each other. They'll tell you, oh, I'm always with my man. I'm always with my woman. You know, we have it anywhere in the living room, in the kitchen, in the bathroom. You know, anywhere we were having fun. Everything was beautiful. Sex was lovely. I was having it. And then suddenly you're like, somehow we just drifted apart. You know, before we used to have sex twice a day, twice a week, 3 times in a week or every day. Suddenly it became once in a month. Once in a month ended up being once in 2 months. Once in 2 months ended up being once in 6 months. And you don't know that your marriage is breaking. You don't think so. So why is that happening? Now, for men, to be fair on men, most men, no matter how long they've been married, their sex drive is still very high. Most, not 100%. Probably out of 100, I would say 80 men, their sex drive is still on the high level. No matter how long they've been married, they are still on the high level. But women, the moment we get married, the moment we start having children, we kind of shift our focus to other things. And we're like, well, I'm not interested. I beg, I'm tired. I've just finished cleaning the house. I just came back from work. I've just did this. Oh, please, please, I can't be bothered. And that is why it is important to have time out. It is important to go on holiday. It is important to rekindle the fire in your relationship. If you cannot rekindle the fire, you cannot, you know, take a break out of all the stress, then there's a problem. There was a gentleman that called me a few months ago that, you know, they just got married to have a son. And he said he doesn't understand what's going on in the marriage. Things are not the way they used to be, blah, 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 that I should pray. I said, my dear, when it comes to marriage, I am not praying. Let us talk. What do you think is happening? I don't need to go into spirit to begin to do rakara bo 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 shandara baba. Who are the enemy that is trying to destroy this marriage? No. Let's talk practicality. What do you think is wrong? What are you doing wrong? What are you doing right? What do you think your woman is also doing wrong or right? And then he said, well, it's more or less since the wife had a baby, she's not really been interested in having sex. And I said, why are you asking me to pray? We know the problem. Let's find a solution. I said, okay. I started asking a lot of questions, ask questions. And then the bottom line is, I said, you know what? You need to go back to the basics. When you were toasting your woman, when you were asking her out, when you were like, hey, babe, I like you. I like this, your dress. Can we go for dinner? You know, there were steps you went through. But the moment we get married, we forget that completely. We just forget it. The only thing is, maybe I'm married. It's her duty to give it to me whenever I want. It's his duty. Yeah, it's the duty, yes. When you get married, you promise my body belongs to you, vice versa. Okay? But at the same time, nobody is a robot. Nobody is a robot. Nobody is a robot. So you need to work things out. Well, thanks for sharing. I can see the number increasing. Thank you all for sharing and for watching. But I'm not getting enough contribution. Happy Boxing Day, Oyedele, Olapeju. Thank you for joining. Seanette McKnight, thanks for joining. Dupe Olajan says going on holiday together is very good. Very good, very important. Take the stress off. We work. We get money. We want to invest, but we don't invest on ourselves. We don't invest in, you know, in our happiness. If we die, all the things we've worked for, other people will enjoy it though. They will enjoy it. So save money for holiday. Especially for those of us that live in Europe. Let's learn something from the people we live with. Save, if it's once in a year, it's not too bad. Save money for holiday. At the end of the day, going back to the story of the young man, I said, listen, you need to find a minder that will look after your child. If your child is going to be an excuse in your marriage every now and then. You know, maybe take the child to your mother-in-law, take the child to a minder, find somebody that will look after your child and take your woman out. Go and watch a movie together. Go and eat out. You know, help in build her libido, increase her libido. Her sex drive is down. Her libido is down. Her interest in sex is down. You need to kick it up. You need to kickstart it again. You need to kickstart it. So what were those things you were doing when you guys started dating before you had a child? Start doing them back. Go back to it. I said, I don't even mind if you can drive down, bring your child to me, I'll look after your child. Take your woman out. So if you just go, just the two of you, forget about work, forget about church. See, a lot of us, church. You don't even have enough time for your family. I'm not saying don't be a Christian. I'm not saying don't be a child of God. I'm not saying don't go to church. But there should be time for everything. There should be time for work, time for God, time for your family. We must learn to create a balance. We must learn to create a balance. Because at the end of the day, even God will ask us, oh, we have a duty to your wife. You have a duty to your husband. You have a duty you need to fulfill. So you need to work on it. You need to create time. And then after a few weeks, I called and asked, how is there any improvement? Is there any changes? He said, yes, auntie, thank you very much. You know, there's improvement. It's not where it used to be, but it's getting better. I said, that's it. Don't stop. What's wrong in going out once every week? What's wrong in going out twice a month? How busy can we be? There's too much stress in the world there. So how are you going to have sex? And how are you going to enjoy it? Okay, when we talk about sex, there's another level of sexual dysfunction. Some men have dysfunctional when it comes to sex. So are some women. You know, because I don't even know how to explain this. Dysfunction is dysfunction. I'm just going to put it there like that. Dysfunction in the sense that they may want things that are out of the book. They may want things that are wayward. They may want things that are too much for you to deal with as a man, as a woman. For instance, your husband comes to you or your wife comes to you and said, listen, I want us to have a threesome. It's all sex related. Things happen in marriage. Things happen. You don't have an idea. Things happened. That's dysfunctional because it's not marriage anymore. Marriage is between a man and a woman. Two people, not three, not talk of four. So that's another level of problem people go through. That's very, very dysfunctional. If man comes, okay, let's have threesome, twosome. In my marriage, you can't keep quiet because that is a big problem. You need to go for counseling for, you need to go for help. That is dangerous. You need to talk about it. You need to resolve it prayerfully, you know, with counseling, in whichever way. And if you Google here, you will see a lot of websites, a lot of group, a lot of charity organizations that are helping with things like this. They are willing to listen to you, to help you. If they can't help you, they will refer you to other people that will help. They will refer you to sexual abuse. A lot of people are being abused in their marriages. It's not only women that get abused, though. Even men get abused. Trust me. Some men will say, ah, what kind of a man is that? You don't know. It's not everyone that's got a strong mind. Some women are very, very manipulative. Very manipulative. I remember a friend was telling me he got married to this white woman. Actually, I've heard about 2-3 people say the same thing. But to white, to English woman, let me put it that way. And because of papers, they want to get paper from them. They are subjected to ridiculous thing. They are more or less like slave men to the women. So even men get abused sexually. They tell you, every day I have to do this, I have to do that. You have to suck the woman for hours, that they went through hell. That's sexual abuse. And they can't say no because of what they want to get from this woman. They can't say no. So if you are going through sexual abuse, you also need to go for help. If you're being abandoned, you know, constructive abandonment in your marriage, you need to go for help. If you're being abused, you need to go for help. Don't keep quiet. Don't suffer in silence. And don't go through it alone. There is help for you out there. If you need somebody to talk to, you can talk to me. If I cannot help you, I will refer you, you know, to other people who can help you better than myself. But don't die in silence. Take control of your life. Take control of your marriage in different levels. Now, do you even know? I'm going to tell you this one. Do you know that you can divorce your husband? You can divorce your wife if you are not sexually satisfied. Oh, yes. I discovered that during my research. You can actually ask for divorce. It's not only until your partner is not sexually faithful to you that you can divorce your partner. But if you are not being satisfied, if your husband is treating you like trash and not giving you that satisfaction, or your wife is not giving you that satisfaction, you can go for divorce. Enough of all these social norms of, oh, I want to please people. I don't want people to condemn me. I don't want people to criticize me. I don't want them to say, oh, she's a useless woman. She left her husband. Oh, he's a useless man. He's not a good man. He left his wife. But what is the point? I'm not preaching divorce. I'm just being practical. What is the point of you being in a marriage when you are just there like a table or a chair? You're just a piece of furniture in the house. No satisfaction in your relationship in any way, and most especially sex. You see a lot of rich, especially, no, I think this happens most to women who marry rich men. Now, you marry a rich man who is financially, when I talk about rich, I mean rich. Before you even go to such a marriage, you know this person is going to be very busy. If you are somebody who has a high libido, you're somebody who has sex, your sex drive is very, very high. Yeah, and you want to, at the same time, you want to marry a very, very rich man. There is a problem. You need to tell yourself the truth. The man is going to be busy. He's going to attend to his business. He wants to keep his business alive. And yet, you want him to be with you 24/7 having sex. There is a problem. Most women like that are the ones that end up having, turning themselves to sugar mommy, where they get young men to sleep with them. Because whether you like it or not, money is important. But sex is also very important. Sex is also very, 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 very important. So when you're choosing a partner and you're looking at the financial status, you're looking for a partner in, you know, you're looking at different reasons and different angle of compatibility, you also need to look at sex. Will this man be available for me? You know, can I just call him out of the blue and say, babes, where are you? Are you coming home now? Where can I meet you? Or where can I hook up with you? Oh, come on, I'm going to be home in the next 3 hours. Okay, where are you going to be? Where is your place? You should know where your husband works. Okay, I'll meet you up. Go get your man from the place of work. And you're like, what's the big deal? What's happening? Say, don't worry. Even though you don't even have to go home. From the office, take your man to an hotel. Do things out of the blue. Do things creative, you know. It doesn't have to be the traditional thing every now and then. Be creative, be crazy. And that's what the man will keep remembering. Say, ungbalori yawo mi, man. Eh? If any woman will come and undress themselves, he'll just look at the man like this way. What do you have? What do you carry? I bet I have better one at home. Thank you, Sister Modupe. They are financially comfortable, but no romance and no good sex. And that drives them out. They go looking for sex out. Those are the people you see online looking for no string attached relationship, just for sex. Money is good though. Trust me. Come and ask me. I need money. Like, even this program I'm doing, if I have money and I have people that are supporting me, you know, what's wrong in me taking, instead of doing it in my living room? What's wrong with me having a studio? What's wrong with me having audiences? What's wrong with me inviting people, you know, do question and answer, do debate, and I've got ideas in my head, but I don't have money to execute it. Okay, but then that's not all about life. Money is good. Sex, but they are very important. Be creative. In your school days, you remember all those adventures you used to do. Why should they stop? Why should they end now that you are married? Some of us will remember school days and you scratches. Hey, child, I do something, so why can't you still be creative now? Keep your man on your tap. Keep that woman asking for more. Not only asking for more, about asking for money. Asking for you more. You go out and your wife is like, when are you coming back? You are getting too late. So, you know, they want to be with you. They want to be around you. Now, there are four stages to sex. The first one is desire. I need to desire you to want you to have sex with you. You need to desire me. Oh, my wife is pretty. I did my makeup this morning. You know, somebody was pretty. Oh, you look pretty. You look chocolating. Oh, I wish I was there, you know, to have a quick one. Yeah. When you dress up, when you finish, your wife or your husband should be able to look at you and say, you know what? Before you go, let's go to the bed quickly. There has to be the desire. You need to look at someone, you know, your partner, and say, yeah. And be triggered. Something should be triggered in you. Somebody said, Adeyemo Sulaimon, it is sweet. Why emphasize on it? I need to emphasize it. Let's stop pretending. I need to emphasize it, Mr. Adeyemo. Because most of the breakups we are having is all about sex. A lot of pastors, yeah, they are married, yet they are sleeping with half of the church. Although some men or some women, there's nothing you can do to please them. They are maniacs. Some people are like that. They have issues. But I'm not talking about those that have issues. I'm talking about those that are normal human beings. Those that are normal human beings. The Olu of Dublin, Prince Lasne, Ada Atondasne, thanks for joining in. For the first time, thanks for joining in. Do share to your Dublin people. Let them watch. We're talking about sex, problems in sex, in marriage. Sexual problem in marriage, the importance of the man and the woman satisfying themselves and having satisfaction. And the truth of the matter is that if your partner is not satisfying you, you can also go for divorce. It's a legal ground. If the law, you know, has made it a legal ground for divorce, now you tell me I should not emphasize on it. When I don't want people to go and have divorce. So let us solve the problem before we get to the stage of the court. I don't want anybody to go to court and go and have a divorce. So call that woman and say, babes, let's try something new today. Yeah, try something new. What's wrong with you putting chocolate all over your woman and licking her from head to toe? Do you hate her that much? Is she that ugly? Does she have skin rashes or kura kura? Give her a lick. What's wrong with that? You know what you like. You know what your woman like. Be free with each other. Explore each other. Explore. Be creative. What does your man want? I hear somebody say, it's a sin for a Christian, you know, to suck the man. It's a sin for a husband to suck the wife. Who told you so? Can you show me where it's written in the Bible? Why do we make law for ourselves and put ourselves under bondage? In marriage, you can explore each other. God created you, both male and female, and you are joined together under holy matrimony. You can explore. Enjoy your wife. Enjoy the wife of your youth. That's what the Bible says. Enjoy that man. Enjoy yourself. Some holy and that will say, I cannot even access before going to church. See, these are little things we do. We create problems for ourselves. Oh, why can't you have sex before going to church? Is it a sin? Sex is not a sin. So you can have sex before going to church. Please, if your man wants sex before church, go and give it to him. If your wife says, my dear, you are dressed up, you've put on your suit, that's fine. But before you go, I need you. Come here. Answer him. And answer her. Fabrique Mola, thanks for joining in. Mutupala says, skin issues can even be taken care of, you see? So if your wife or your husband has skin issues, look after them. Assist them to get better. Appreciate them. Olumeyo, thanks for joining in. Sex is very sweet with your wife when you can handle her well. It ruins many marriage and homes. Thank you very much, sir. And that is the truth. That I still have some few men on my tab who still call now and then. And I'm still in the process of counseling, advising, and pushing them back to their wife. Work with your wife. Teach your wife. All those skills that are in your brain that you want to go and practicalize with another woman, teach your woman. And you, woman, listen and learn. Omobasi, the elders cannot have sex before church, ma. Especially from our side. That is for Celestial Church of Christ and for the White Garment Churches. Okay, that's minority out of majority. And even under that minority, ma, if your husband is an elder in the church, you as a woman need to respect and give them room for that day or for the 3 days before then. But even at that, if your wife needs you, you need to answer your wife. Oh yes, quote me anywhere. If your husband is an elder and you as the wife, you cannot control yourself. Instead of lusting in the church, be angry in the church, you need to answer to your wife. That's what the Bible says. Not law made by man. If your husband, if your wife needs you and you're an elder in the church, you need to attend to your wife. The only thing you will do is that you will not enter the altar. Stay among the congregation for that day. The world will not come to an end. If within a month, within one Sunday in a month, the women don't get to put on their sutana and go into the church. So also, if you, the man, probably once in a month or two times even in a month, if you don't sit in the altar, the world will not come to an end. Stop depriving your wife of her pleasure. Stop depriving her with the excuse of I have to go to church. Oh, in the head, I have to enter the altar. Leave the altar now. Now by force, must you enter the altar every day? Must you be clean every day? It is not a sin. So please your wife. Please your husband. And then there's Jesus Christ. There's one story ahead. Oh my God. I don't know how the woman married the man, no, because me, I cannot marry such a man. No. I can talk my own. She said, the man is so used. Let me not say use that word. He said, the man just sleeps on her, and she's just there like furniture. And then the man just go like that. And then she's like, can he go faster? And the man will say, I can't go faster than this. Oh, this is all I can do. I say, hey, can I have fun now? Will it be this one? I say, they try, oh. But, and I'm like, how did you even marry such a man in the first place if you know that that's not good enough for you? Oh, okay, I'm a saint. You never tested it before you got married, Abby. Tell yourself the truth. Okay, maybe you never tested, but you never kissed? You never, I don't know. How does it happen? How do you marry such? But if you know you are cool with that, you also don't have problem. If it's a missionary style you like to, no wahala. Everybody will stay like that. What is wrong with you being creative? Put your man on the seat, man, and sit on him. Does he always have to be on the bed? What happened to you going to the kitchen? What about the staircase? The children go to school, you know. When they go to school and there's nobody at home, scatter the whole house after you rearrange it. Even if the children are at home, do it quick in the bathroom. Be creative. Remember the pack. Don't go in the winter, cold go finish you. During the summertime, go to the park. Go for a walk with your man. Just hold a blanket. Go for a walk. Leave the children at home. Go for a walk in the park. Put your blankets on the floor. Have a nice time. Stay under the moon. You know, fresh air, everything, nature. Appreciate one another. You know, be a child again. Be a teenager once in a while. Be a teenager. Be a teenager. Be friends. Be lovers. Omobasi, stop laughing. I'm saying the truth. Stop laughing. Abishek, Abi, where I live. Ah, what do you want to do with where I live? What has where I live got to do with what I'm talking about? Take your time. Olumi, some men believe in dying on girlfriend. Why they don't care to touch their wives for months? Eat your wife raw and let her feel like a woman. Hey, under you, not swearing for you. I cannot continue to read that. You people should read it yourself. You're in another world. But it's true, though. That's true. Some men have girlfriends out there where they express themselves with the woman. They do anything and everything with the woman. But at home, how are you? Where's my food? They eat and that's it. But outside, they are best of lovers. They are good lovers. They will spoil the woman with everything. And I mean everything, not just money. Even sexually. And the woman will be like, when are you coming again? So that means you don't love your woman. That means you've lost interest in your woman. And such a woman has the right to divorce you. Such a woman has every right to divorce you. Don't be deceived. So many times it's because we don't know our right as a woman and as a man. We don't know our right as a being. We don't know even the law. The law changes every day because people change. You know, laws are made for reasons. Laws are made for reasons. Shola Alade Sonmi. Hey, thanks for joining in. Long time no see. Laws are made for reasons. So if your man or your woman is not pleasing you, you've done everything in the book, you've gone to see sex therapies, you've gone for coaching, and nothing is happening, instead of suffering there and being unfaithful, you can bail out. It's not a crime. Under law, you can bail out. I'd rather be free than be in prison. Okay, first stages. I need to round up. First stages is desires. Sex, being sexy, taught or sexually attracted to one another, or triggered by seeing somebody, by smell, by perfume, which also means you want to attract your man. Look nice. It doesn't have to be until you put makeup. Dress nice. Dress sexy. Put on nice perfume. It doesn't have to be the perfume that will even choke you. You know? Then you just pass through him and you just hear that smell. The wind just blows it in. And he inhales. That alone can trigger his emotions. That can trigger your emotions. Can trigger your emotions. You know, your dressing triggers emotion. The movie you watch triggers emotion. Okay? And then with all that comes arousal. Arousal could be excitement you feel for your partner. And could be even from the physical touch. The arousal begins to come up. You know? And then it changes, you know, physiologically, your body almost begins to change. You begin to get aroused. Starting from desire. Do I even like my husband? Do I want him? And then it changes to arousal. You get aroused, physically stimulated to the point of orgasm. And that is the peak of it all. I do not see the reason why you will have sex with your wife and your husband and the both of you will not get to the point of orgasm. It doesn't make sense. Why wouldn't your wife be satisfied? And then you will now say, that was a nice one. It was a lovely one. I enjoyed it. And the one is looking at you like, I am not satisfied yet. Sorry, maybe my face is not nice. And then, oh, are you sure? Oh, I thought you came the other time. Don't thought I came the other time. Be sure that I came. Ah, I thought you came. It's the wrong word, though. I can punch your face. Don't thought. No. Make sure your wife came. Your wife is satisfied. And don't just darale and just say, oh, it's over. You begin to blow yourself. Ah, I need a cold water. I know water for you until the mission is over. Make sure your woman is satisfied. You need to know your, what is it called now? The G-spots. Explore your wife, explore your husband, know the G-spot. What are roses are? What gets her in the mood easily? What does she like? What are the things, you know, you can say to her that will get her turned, you know, turned in? You need to know these things. What's the point of your marriage? Is it only to work and make babies and a glorified house help to feed you? Hell no. Moses, Juliet, thank you, really. Love what you are saying. I pray God should give good man love to you, my amen. Thank you very much for the prayer. Thank you very, very, very much. I appreciate that. So either you're married or you're not married, know and know what you're settling down for. Know what you're settling down for. Okay, I need to rush. Then after the orgasm is resolution, your body will return to the resting state. A lot of men do this. After sex is over, you just see them get up and then go to have a shower. I don't think it's complete the stage of sex. When you're done, relax. Even if you are sweating, you know, get a fan, got a hand towel, dry your body, but stay in bed with your woman. The woman don't want to go and clean anything. There's nothing to clean. Stay with your man. Embrace each other. Embrace each other, you know. Keep that communication. Embrace each other and talk. Relax in the bosom of each other. Appreciate each other. In the process of the appreciation and the process of you, you know, calming down, relaxing, and your hormones are really settling down, you can rekindle the fire and go for number two. But you just finish, I just jump off, you go and wash yourself. Why? Does she irritate you that much? Maybe she doesn't irritate you, but you don't feel comfortable, you want to clean yourself. If you have to clean yourself, 2 seconds, be back on bed. And stay there for a few more minutes. Relax with each other. Relax, relax. Don't rush. We understand there can be days for quickie, but if you want to have it, please do have it well and enjoy it well. If it's your amala, you are eating now, you farabala and enjoy it. You all enjoyed your turkey yesterday. So please give this woman a break. Let them enjoy. A lot of women, for them, is the other way around. It's not desire first before arousal. Rather, it's arousal. You need to arouse them before they desire you. Especially when women start having children. You know, their focus kind of changes a little bit. So you need to help the woman. You need to arouse them. What works for your woman? Is it by touching her neck? You know, is it by touching her hands? Start from, or is it by talking? You know, you look very nice. I love your hair. I love your lips. Oh, it's very suckable. You know, I like to play with you. You know, go near her, begin to touch her. She may be doing shakara. We are like that. Leave me, Joe. I'm not in the mood. Ignore those tactics. Keep pressing your button. Keep pressing it. Keep touching. And before you know it, she said the tone will change to, I'm not interested to. She's still doing shoulder, but the tone is changing. You know, the tone is changing. And with time, it will change from arousal and desire will work together. And then she will let go. She will release herself for you. So don't quickly give up. Men, don't quickly give up. Don't quickly give up if the woman is doing shakara. Don't. We multitask. So sometimes we are with you, but we are not with you. Our mind is there. Okay, I need to make dinner. I need to do shopping. I need to do the kids' laundry. And our brain is multifunctioning. So to get the woman back into the mood, you men, you can switch easily like that. We don't switch easily. Know that one now. Keep it though. We don't switch easily. So you need to bring the woman back. From all the miles she has gone to, she has traveled. Her mind has traveled to Sokoto, to Maiduguri, to America. You need to bring all those minds that have scattered everywhere. You need to bring it all back home. With the touching, with the talking, with sweet talk, you know. Talking about life. Oh, I remember the last time we went to this place. Oh, I remember that place was lovely. You know, that dress you wore to church yesterday was really lovely. I love it. And I'm going to get you under, you know. Talk to her. Not just empty promises, things you're never gonna do. God, that is gonna cause another wahala. Me, I told you. So even when you are talking and you are packaging your woman, watch your words so that they don't sue you with the words you said. And she be yesterday, you said you were going to buy me. You say, hey, when did I say that? I am not involved though. So even when you're talking, be careful what you are saying. Don't say because you just want to get into her panties. That's why you are saying all those grammar. What you are saying, also watch it so that it doesn't put you into trouble. Don't say it is joking that I told you to be talking. This is relationship talk with Mudukpe. We talk factual. Wale Michael, some women, when they are not in the mood, they won't react no matter what you say. Yes, no matter what you say. So why wouldn't they react to you? You need to know you and you need to know your woman. What works for you may not work for somebody else. Why won't they react to you even if you are saying something? Then go to physical. Start touching. Start touching. She's not going to push you or slap you. If she pushes you away, you can leave her for a few seconds and then go back to it. You can say, oh, baby, let's go have a shower. Why? I've had my bath already this morning. I don't want to shower. Yeah, but they're just going to have a shower, you know. You must know your woman. You must know what works for her. Have you upset her? Then make peace. You must know her. That's the essence of you being partners. Know what works. Know her. I know how to get my... She is my wife. Don't worry, I know how to handle her. You must know how to handle her. Even if she's angry or she's even having issues with people or her family, you must know how to handle your woman. When they come to report her to you, if you say, hey, my wife did this, hey, my wife did that, don't worry, I'll sort it out. You must know how to sort it out. You must know her. For some women, you cannot shout at them, it won't work. You cannot do, I'm your husband, you must do this. It will not work. For some, you sit them down and talk. My dear, what happened? Why did you do this? You advise. Some women, you have to be like their daddy and talk to them like daddy. You cannot do boss. So it's all about understanding. Omoba said, oh yes, we multitask and men should try and be patient because women love attention. Attention. Yes, we do. So you want good sex? Give me that attention. Let me know that I matter, that I'm important to you. Carry me like eggs. Say, hey, my wife, oh, you must not follow. My wife, oh, I must pamper, oh, my wife, oh. Then we will go to places for you. We will move mountains for you. We will jump any mountain, any hill. We will climb, we will jump for you. Before you say Jack Robinson, we are there. Don't just seem like, okay, I've had sex today, then I can just dump her. Then when I need her again, then I'll not come and start doing. We are not fools, though. We know the signs. So when you carry me and keep me there. Don't carry me and drop me. Carry me and keep me there. That's what women are. Women, too, start doing too much shakara. If the man wants it from the back, give it to him. If he wants it for 10 minutes, 10 minutes is 10 minutes. There was something I read about, somebody was saying that, why would you be having sex in your marriage for, I needed to be sure my son is not listening. Nobody is dropping. No, he's dropping. And Moses Jesus said, I can't wait to marry you. God will give you your own husband who will appreciate you. why did you have to do this? Don't worry, God will bless you with your own husband who will appreciate you and who will give it to you just the way you want it. Mike says, some women are like that. No matter what you, how you romance her, you do all sorts of things to Arusa, yet she won't be in the mood. Then there is a problem. You need counseling. You need to get to the bottom of it. She's not like that by accident. You need to get to the bottom of it. Why is she like that? You know? Why is she? There is a big gap. If things are that bad, there is a big vacuum that needs to be refilled quickly before it's too late. You need to go for counseling. And you will be surprised at the outcome. You'll be surprised when she begins to tell you what happened 2 years ago, you did this, 3 years ago, it's because you did this, that's, and you will be surprised what you will hear. So you need to get to the bottom of that problem, if that is happening. If, as for the woman, you've tried everything and nothing is working, get to the bottom of the problem. The problem is bigger than sex. So you need counseling, you need help. If such is happening in your marriage, if such is happening in your relationship, you need help. Quick one, even. Okay, I need to... I don't even know what time. I started 1 o'clock. What's the time? Oh, no. I'm rounding up now. Okay? I think I've touched everything I need to touch. Sexual experience is important for both parties. Your spouse may have higher sex drives more than you. And if you cannot manage it during courtship, don't marry. Men have more hard work to do on their wives' sexual desires, because even your satisfaction is tied to it. For a man to be satisfied sexually and even otherwise, you know, you have a lot of hard work to do to keep your woman there. Because if your woman is not happy, if your woman doesn't give you what you want, you're also not going to be happy. You're also not going to be satisfied. And it goes vice versa. And there are times that honestly, there is no problem, there is no issue, there is no spiritual attack. You know, you're not just in the mood. It happens. You also need to understand that and let it be. It's not, oh, if I need it now, you must give it to me now by fire, by force. You know, so sometimes you also need to like, maybe she's tired, let me leave her alone. My husband has worked all day, he just came back. You know the kind of work he does. So men also need help. You know the kind of work he does. Maybe he's doing a factory work, he's been working all day, his back is gone, and he wants you to come and be doing Jan Grover. Sometimes you take the lead, you do the Jan Grover, you be on top. And let him relax. You know, if you are on top, you take charge. So he is also relieved and he can sleep well. That is a paracetamol, free paracetamol without any side effects. Give him food, let him have a shower, and you take charge, be on top. Let him be relieved, let him have a good sleep. You know the kind of work he does, you know how tiring it could be. For some people, their work is mentally draining. It may not be physical, it may be mentally drained. So you also need to understand that, be understanding. It's not all about you all the time, you know. That's the essence of relationship. Also consider, what does he want? Is he happy? Men, stop looking for anything out there. Women, stop looking, searching for nonsense. Fight to keep your home. Your home is worth a fight. Fight to keep it. Fight to keep it in prayer. Fight to keep it in your attitude. Fights to keep it sexually. Do your best. I just remembered something. Some women complain bitterly that my husband wants me to suck him, but he doesn't want to suck me. That's a big problem, but that's very, very selfish. Very, very selfish. You want your woman to suck you, but you don't want to suck her. It's not fair. But for you, the woman that you want them to suck you, are you clean? How clean are you? Do you clean yourself properly? Do you clean yourself? He's a human being. If he tries even to play with you down there and he gets there and his, and some horrible smell just slap his face, he will remove his face. So you also need to clean yourself. Not only when you need to, but you need to clean yourself every time, all the time. When you keep the place clean, it will be smell-free. It will be smell-free, and then he will be comfortable to also please you there. Some men don't like their women to shave. Some women don't like their men to shave. So these social norms of everybody have to shave, you don't have to. If your woman or your man doesn't like it, don't shave. Maybe that's what attracts him. That's what turns him on. So don't shave, oh. Don't say because people are shaving, I have to shave. You can trim it down. But don't shave if you don't have to shave. And if your man likes you clean shaved, then have a clean shave. If you don't want to go for waxing, there are so many ways you can go about it. I need to run out. So you also need to find ways to help yourself. I believe I've been able to wake some people up from their slumber. I've made your butt today not too boring, I believe. Okay, but share the program, bless somebody with it, and learn. As long as we are in this world, learning doesn't stop. Learn how to please your wife. Learn how to please your husband. Learn how to please your children. Learn how to be happy. You don't know that in pleasing your husband, it makes you happy. You please your wife, it makes you happy. Because when you see their joy, you see that satisfaction. You know, when you write dates on them, it's like an energy. It bounces back on you. You feel happy. You feel excited as well. Michael says, have been dating a girl for like... I've been dating a girl for like 3 years. And up till now, I can't get down with her. Telling me to wedding night. Which wedding night? I beg. Help me warn her. Today na Boxing Day. Okay, I don't know. Is anybody going to help me with that? Because I don't... Dating a girl for 3 years. And she's saying it's a Boxing Day. Well, what are you also waiting for? 3 years is a long time. Don't you know what you want? Can't you make up your mind? Why, go ahead and marry her then. 3 years is a long time. If you are sure she meets all other criteria, then why not go for wedding? Are you sexually attracted to her? Why not go for wedding? What's stopping you? What's holding you? Exactly, Sister Ngozi. Why would you date her for 3 years? Marry her now by fire. Waiting 3 years. What are you waiting for? Must you enter the pants? Must you go to the red zone before you marry her? Are you sure you want to marry her? Are you sure? You don't have to do big wedding. You people should stop deceiving yourself and wasting your time. Don't wait until you have millions. Don't wait until you have millions before you marry. Do your quiet wedding. JJ, family A, family B. Sit down. Join together. Go to your house. Go to registry. Only you and your best man. Go to registry. Sign the document. Go home. Chikena. You don't need to call the whole world. So stop finding excuses. Stop looking for excuses. Adebayo Adejimo. Seriously, this is seductively educating. Blast the brass with fire. Hey, Holy Ghost fire. Amen. Michael says, it's not my fault. I think she's avoiding me. This 2020, we are looking there. I need to get a new girlfriend. No time for yeye girlfriend. This man is not serious. If she's avoiding you, we need to be sure 100% if she's dating somebody else. If she's not dating somebody else, why is she avoiding you? That means she doesn't want to be with you. And if she's not ready to go to the altar with you, move on. 3 years is a long time. I'm sure you're an adult. I cannot see your face. But I'm sure you're not a teenager. If you're of the marriageable age, I don't see what you are wasting your time for. Purpose driven says, 3 years is long ago. If you are sure she is for you, then you should satisfy her by also making her your wife so she can in turn suit your sexual desires. Amen, somebody. Okay, it's been lovely. It's been nice chatting with you all, talking. It's Boxing Day. Most people are not working today. So if your man is there, get your red wine out. Some shops are still open. So if you don't have red wine, go and buy one, or white wine. But I think red wine works better. You know, works the magic. If you have some leftover chicken or anything to nibble on, sit on the set, put on a nice movie. Watch nice movie with your partner. you know, with your wife. If your own is not around, sorry for you. Bele, no verse. Manage. If your children are around you, watch movie, have some nice glass of wine, and go to bed. Close the window, close the curtains, and go and have a nice time. Explore. Remember, explore. Explore each other. Remember, be creative. Why do you have a dining table if you cannot use it? I beg, use the dining table. Use the setting. Use the kitchen. Use the step. Sometimes, get out of the house. Okay, I don't want to be repeating myself. All right, till I meet you again, remember, it is not allowed for you to give up on love. Ngozi says, if she is the problem, it's possible she does not love you the way you do. So pack your load to another woman. Shikena. 3 years, you should know what you want. 3 years, you should know where the relationship is going. You know, you're smart. So know what you're doing. All right. Okay. Thank you for joining, Mr. Michael Bami. And I thank God that we've been able to help you. And the only way we could help you was because you spoke up. So it's very important for people to speak up, talk, so that people know what you're going through and they can advise you. Some will advise you wrongly, some will advise you rightly. But in between, you'll be able to create a balance. You'll be able to pick the important information you need that will help you to make the right decisions. And I believe God will bless you with the right person. All those that are watching, God bless you. Oh, it's Boxing Day. What do I do now? I think I want to go back to bed. I want to go back to bed. Okay? Have a nice one. I'll see you in New Year 2020. What is your New Year resolution? I'm pleasing my husband more. She'll be one of them. I don't want to go out again to see those women. I want to find out what my woman likes, what my woman loves, and how I can please my wife better. That should be on your resolution list for 2020. Leave the dating sites alone. No, I'm watching. If I catch you there, leave all the dating sites alone. Leave all the singles there alone. Let them find good wife and good husbands. Stay with your husband. Stay with your wife. And practicalize. Go out. In fact, you don't even need to buy CD. Blue Movie. You don't need to buy. It's free online. If you need me to give you the site, inbox me privately. I will give you you can watch 1 million in one day. Now you go tire. Olo milo mare. So there's no way you buy it. By the time you watch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blue film that you'll be done with your husband already. You'll be done with your wife. No matter how strong-headed your wife may be, no matter how kokoroko she can toughen herself, before she watches 3, 4, 5, the match will be over. Shine your eye. Yara in brain. Alright, this has been Relationship Talk with Modupe. Till I see you next time, enjoy the rest of the holiday. Thank you and God bless. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things, all the bad things, baby. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things, all the bad things.